to the races here, guys. We're going to start off with our warm-up. So we are going to start with our arms straight out to our sides. Little circles going forward. Little circles going forward. And getting those circles a little bit bigger.
Nice, Finn. Get your body all warmed up and awake.
Big as you can go. Big as you can go.
Nice, Kaden.
Big circles, Kaden. That's pretty cool.
Arms are back out to our side.
Nice, Ben.
Little circles going backwards this time. Little circles going.
Good job, Jay.
Direction. Getting slightly bigger. Slightly bigger.
And nice circles, Alex.
As big as you can go. Perfect. All right. We're going to take, pardon me, left foot. We're going to take one big step forward. We're going to put our hands on our knee. Going to lean forward. Keep that back foot planted. Make sure your heel isn't coming off the ground. Lean forward.
Edward, Dennis, nice work. I like how you're participating. Good job, Ellie.
And we're going to switch what we do to one side. We want to do to the other side. So our right foot is going to go forward. Hands on our knee. And we're going to lean forward. Lean forward.
Nice lean, everybody. Get that stretch in.
Oh, good work. And we're going to go hands on our hips. Okay, we're going to open up our hips. We're going to do our butt and our core is going to go all the way around in a big circle. Our feet aren't moving. Okay, getting all of our trunk, our torso here all warmed up. Nice big circles.
Nice, Ben. Nice hip circles, you two, Kaden, Alex.
One more around.
Fantastic.
Go the other direction now, so back the other way.
Nice job, Rahi.
Good stuff, you guys.
Good job, Gabriel.
Good stuff, good stuff. All right, we are going to take our right foot now. Point your toe to the ground. We're going to do little ankle circles, so get those ankles nice and warmed up here. Okay, little ankle circles. Good job, you guys. And just like we said before, what we do to one side, we do to the other. So, left foot, point, toe, and little circles with our ankles here.
Nice, Finn. I see you warming up all those body parts. Good job, Ellie, you too. Nice ankle rolls, Alex.
Nice work, you guys. All right. So the first thing we are going to work on today, we are going to work on all of our lower body. So this is going to be our calves and our hamstrings and all that good stuff there, our thighs in the front. So very simple. We've done the lunges before. So if you guys remember what the lunges were, you're standing straight up. You would take one step forward. Your knee would go down and then you would come up. Okay. We're going to make it a little bit more complicated this week. So we are going to do what's called split jumps. Okay. So what you do for the split jump is the exact same thing as we do for the lunges. Okay. So the one step forward, down, but then you're up. Okay. You're actually going to switch feet. Okay. So what that looks like, we go down, up, down, up, down, up, down. Okay, so you notice how if I'm looking at my legs, we sort of start like this, like this, like this, like this. So we go back and forth, okay? And so what we're gonna try and do, we're gonna try and do 20 seconds. Do that twice. So we're gonna do one real quick practice round. I wanna see everyone do it three times, just so that we can see that we've got the motion down, then we'll actually start our timer. Okay, so this one doesn't count. We're only doing it three times, but I want to see you guys try and do it. Okay, so you guys do it with me here. We'll start with our left leg going forward. Down.
All right, Edward, let's see it. Let's see you do this.
Switch. Two. Down. Switch. Three.
Keep going.
Good job, guys.
Nice work.
Nice work, Kaden.
Good job, Finn.
Good work, you guys.
Ellie, awesome. Nice okay. work.
So, Everybody freeze. Good work, Ellie. Love it. Okay. What we really want to try and do here, that was really, really good. Okay. What you want to make sure you're also doing, though, it's not just, right? We can all switch our legs like this. What you want to make sure you do is when you switch, we go down. So see that down motion? That's what we want. Okay. Then switch down, down. Okay. So we're going to do it twice, 20 seconds each time. Okay. So I'm going to start the timer for the first one. Everyone get ready. There's nothing around you. You're going to hit. Ready, set, go. Down, switch.
Good job, Finn. Switch. Nice lunges.
Nice job, Kaden.
Guys.
Hard.
Nice work, Kaden. You're over halfway done. Over halfway done.
Ellie, keep it up. You're doing great. Nice split lunges.
Two, one. Everybody freeze. Good job. We'll do a quick break here. You can catch your breath, and then we'll do our second set. If you want, you can give your legs a little wiggle. Make sure they're not turning into jelly for you there. Five more seconds. Everyone's getting ready here. All right, let's get back into our positions. Okay, same thing. 20 more seconds and we're done this exercise, okay? Ready, three, two, one, go. Down, switch, switch.
All right, Edward, let's see you do it. You did so good the first time. Nice, Finn. Keep it up. You're doing fantastic. You guys are almost done. Good job, Gabriel. Keep working hard.
Job. Five, four, three, two, one. Good job, you guys. Really, really, really good work there.
Well, that looked hard, Coach Kyle.
Oh, it was a tough one. All right. Our next one, let's see where I can get some room here. All right. Our next one, we are going to be on the floor for. So if you want, everyone can sit down on your bums. Everyone can sit on your bums. Oh, I see some cameras getting adjusted. I love it. Perfect. Okay. So for this one, you're gonna have your knees up in a triangle, okay? So knees up in a triangle, just like this. Your arms, you're gonna put flat on the ground beside you, okay? So they don't need to be behind your head or somewhere crazy, just flat on the ground beside you. What we are gonna do here, we are gonna do hip thrusters, okay? So we're gonna do 20 hip thrusters. And what that looks like, very simply, is your butt comes off the ground, and then back down, okay? So your butt comes up, your hips, you're trying to put your belly button to the sky, essentially, okay? We're gonna do that 20 times, all right? So everyone's got arms beside them, legs are in a triangle. On the count of three, we are gonna start, and we'll count them out loud, okay? Ready? One, two, three, go. One, two, three.
Nice, Rocky. You're doing four, great.
Five.
Work, everybody.
Keep it up, everybody. You're six, halfway there.
Seven.
Three. Nice, Kaden.
Eight. Nine.
And good job. You're almost eight, done.
11. 12. 13. 14.
Good job, Edward. Keep it up.
Five.
Keep it up.
16, 17, 18, two more, 19, and last one, 20. Good job, you guys. And we can take a little breather here, and we'll do one more set, and then that'll be our first water break of the day, okay? So we can do a little breather. If your legs are a little bit jelly, you can give them a little kick. Get them moving around from the last exercise we did. Five more seconds. All right, let's get everyone back down onto the ground if you stood up. Same position. So again, make sure your legs are a nice little triangle. You don't want them too far away because that makes it really hard to get your butt off the ground. So you want them nice and close to your butt. Nice triangle. Okay. Arms flat on the ground beside you. All right. 20 more and then a water break. Ready? Here we go. One, two, three.
Good job, Ellie.
Four.
Keep it up, Edward.
Six. Seven.
Edward, let's see you do it.
Eight.
Nice, Rahi.
Nine. Ten.
Nice, Alex.
11.
Nice bridges, everybody.
12. 13.
Good job. Keep it up.
14.
Oh, 15, that's harder version.
5. 16. 17. 18. Two more. 19. And 20. Good
job. Nice work, everyone.
All right. So that brings us to our first water break of the day. So you can go and grab a quick drink of water.
All right, I need to go use the washroom.
Okay, that's fine, Zach.
I'll be right back.
You're working us hard today. Good, buddy.
I'm going to use the washroom.
Yeah, buddy. Yeah, buddy. Yeah.
Is everybody sweating yet?
Yeah, buddy. Yes.
Are you sweating?
Yeah, I am definitely sweating a lot.
Good.
I think it was your lunches.
Yeah, those lunches are hard.
No, not hard to me.
Oh, then you must be in better shape than I am, because I struggle with those ones.
Big shape. You work out 3 times a week.
Yeah, that's good.
10 more seconds for water break.
Oh, yeah.
Edward, don't drink too much. You got a stomach ache.
All right, we can put our water bottles back off to the side there, you guys. Now,
I didn't see any though.
Legs, and then we did our hips. Okay, so for this one, we're going to be focusing on our core here. So these are going to be called reverse crunches. So again, you're going to need to clear a space on the ground. Make sure there's nothing near you. All right. Everybody's going to lie on their back, just like we were before. Now, if you remember the crunches that we did a few weeks ago, you were coming up this way, right? And you were making sort of a sandwich and you were crunching your abs. Okay. Now, we're going to be doing similar, but it's a reverse crunch. So instead of you coming up to your legs, you're gonna bring your legs up to you, okay? So see how it's my upper body stays flat on the ground here, right? My shoulders, my chest, all of that is staying flat, and it's my butt that comes off the ground and my legs, right? Okay, we are gonna do that 12 times twice, okay? So just let's all do one practice one before we start counting. Okay, so everyone lay flat on our backs. That's good job, Ellie. Good work. Okay.
Nice job, Edward.
We're going to bring our butt and our legs up. Ready? One, two, three. Up.
Nice, Edward.
One.
Good job, okay. Finn.
So we're going to do that 12 times. Are we ready? Three, two, one. Here we go. One, two.
Good job, Caden.
Three.
Nice job, Jay.
Good job,
Jay, you can lay flat on your back if you want. That might be easier. There you go.
Six.
Perfect.
Seven. Eight.
Good job, Alyssa. Nine. Good job, volunteers.
10. 11.
Nice, Ellie. Wow. Good work.
Good job. Yeah, some of you looked like you were having a lot of fun with that one there. That's good. Nice work. Love it. All right, we'll do a quick little breather here. Everyone can catch our breath, right? Then we got 12 more, okay? Very good, you guys. Always like giving you guys new exercises rather than doing the same ones over and over again, because then it lets you guys pick which ones you like the best. And then when you guys are at home yourselves, you can do those ones. This one seemed to be pretty popular. So lots of people enjoying doing the little back rolls there. All right, 5 more seconds so everyone can get back into our original position. Back into our original position. All right, so same thing. We've got 12 more and then this exercise is done. All right, so hands on the ground, off to our sides. Okay, getting ready to get those butts up off the ground in 3, 2, 1. Here we go. 1, 2, 3.
Alex.
Keep it up, Alex. Keep it up, Edward. Finn, you're doing fantastic. I love those leg lifts, guys.
Good job, guys.
8, 9, 10.
Keep working hard, 12. Ellie. You're doing fantastic.
12. Good job, you guys.
Nice, Kaden.
Really, really, really good work. Nice. Love it. Love it. All right. So our next one, while you guys are taking a quick breather, we're also going to be on the ground on our back. All right. So this is why I said today, you really needed to make sure there's nothing on the ground. We're going to be spending a lot of time on the ground here today. This one, when we're on our backs, okay, what we're going to try and do is we're going to have our legs straight up and we're going to try and touch our toes 10 times. And we'll do that twice and then we'll do our second water break of the day. Okay, so all it is, and you've got one of two options really. If you want, you can get your butt close to a wall, all right, and then you can try and touch your toes this way. You can get your feet up that way. If you have a little bit of trouble keeping them straight up, you can put your feet, your heels onto the wall and then try and do our toe touches. Okay. Or if you want, you can have them straight up and then try and reach them that way. So it's your choice. All right. So whatever is easier for you guys. All right. So everyone should be on the ground. Okay. I'll do the first one with my feet on the wall. Then I'll do the second set of 10 without them on the wall, just so you guys can see both ways, okay? So all you're trying to do, you're not trying to go all the way up and actually touch your toes, okay? It's like little mini crunches just with your legs elevated, okay? So just see how your shoulders are just getting off the ground like that. That's all you need to do. As soon as you feel some burn in your tummy, you're doing it right, all right? So everyone, I'll give you one more second, okay?
If you don't have a wall, you can put your legs up on a couch or a chair too. That would work too.
As well too, right? Or even if you have a parent there, they can hold your legs up, okay? So we're gonna do this 10 times. And again, if you're keeping up with my pace, great. If you're faster, great. If you're slower, that's fine too. Just make sure we all do 10, okay? Ready, 3, 2, 1, here we go. 1, 2.
Good work, Gabriel. Reach for your toes. Good job.
Five.
Nice. And keep reaching for those toes.
7.
Keep going, 8. Ellie. You're good almost job. There.
9. 10. Good seven. Job, you guys. Really good work. So even though it's your legs that were up and your shoulders that were moving, where did you feel the burn? Probably your tummy, right? Because those are your ab muscles there, right? That's all your core muscles. That's what's actually helping pull your body up off the ground. It's not your shoulders that are using the muscles to get off the ground. It's all those tummy muscles right there. Okay?
So for this one, I'll do it without the wall, just so everyone can sort of see the two different ways you can go about it. But you guys don't have to switch. If you were perfectly comfortable with your first way around, you can do it again. All right. We're getting ready. So on the count of three, we need 10 more, and then our second water break of the day. Ready? One, two, three. Here we go. One, two.
Nice work, Jay. Keep three, going.
Four, five.
Working hard, everyone.
Six, seven.
Nice.
Good job, Gabriel.
Nine, 10.
Good job, Zach.
Good job. As soon as you've done your 10, you've earned your second water break of the day. We'll grab a quick drink of water.
Ben, you look like you're working hard over there.
Everyone's working hard today.
Mm-hmm.
Jumpy chef for me.
Edward, you were working hard today. Good job.
Thank you.
Is everyone's tummy sore after those ones?
Hey, Coach Carr, my stomach's feeling very worked out.
Feeling very worked out? That is good.
Good, bud.
Means you're doing it right.
I bet Coach Carr.
All right, while you're finishing up your water break there, if you can locate your cans or your weights, we are gonna need them for the next exercise. Give you guys another 10 seconds to get water and locate your cans and weights. All right, show me at the camera your cans or weights there. Let me see that everyone's got them. A little shake. Good stuff. Awesome. All right, so for these ones, these are called tricep kickbacks. So if you guys remember, there's essentially two main parts to your arm muscles, right? The front part here that helps with curls, right? Those are your biceps. Okay, this back part of your arm, all right, those are called your triceps. All right, and so I'll show you what the kickbacks look like from the side. All right, so you can see them a little bit better. You sort of want to be bent over. All right, your arm is going to be straight at a 90 degree, and you're going to kick back and make it straight. Okay, kick back and make it straight. So this goes from a hanging, nice 90 degree position here, where you can see, all right, just straight back out and back. Now, again, just like all of our other weight exercises there, it's not a race, so I don't want to see anyone doing this, all right? It's all the way extend, hold for like 1 second, and then slowly come back. All the way extend, hold at the top, all the way back. All right, now you're going to be doing it with both arms simultaneously. Okay, so you're actually going to be like this, bent over, both arms go back. All right, you can't really see my left one, but if I turn this way, both arms are going. Okay, bent to straight back. Now we are going to do that 12 times. Okay. And we're going to do 2 sets of them. All right, 12 reps, 2 sets. Okay, so what I need everyone to do, make sure you've got your cans in both hands. Okay, I'll turn sideways so you can see. Get a little knee bend action here. Bend over.
Alex, bring your feet in a little bit closer.
All right, arms.
There you go, perfect.
And then straight back and back. All right, so we're going to start counting now. Ready? Here we go. One, two, three, four, six. We're halfway there.
Good job, everyone.
Gabriel.
Eight. Nine. Ten. Two more. 11. 12. Good job. Put your cans down. If you want, you can give your arms a little bit of a wiggle. Okay, so that was one set. We've got one more to go here. Give yourself a little bit of a breather. All right. Everyone seemed to have the basic motions down. That was great. I loved it. Okay. We'll pick up our cans or our weights again. Okay. Everyone will get in their positions. 12 more. All right. Ready? So we're going to get in our positions. Bend over. Should have our arms at 90 degrees here. 12 more. Ready? 3, 2, 1. One.
Good job, Rahi.
Good job, Rahi. 3, 4.
Good work, Jay.
5.
1.
6.
Nice, Finn. Nice tricep extensions.
9. Good job, Kaden. 10. 2 more. 11. And 12. Good job, you guys. All right. Put your cans off to the side. All right. Now, this time we are going to do very similar to what our push-ups were, but we're going to add a little bit of a twist to it, right? So we're adding little things each week. So everyone remembers your basic push-up, right? There's two ways you can do it, depending on your level of comfort. There's the assisted push-up, right? So that's when we've got your knees, our hands are shoulder width apart, chest goes down and comes up, right? And then there's the traditional push-up, back is nice and straight, chest goes down, chest goes up, okay? What we're gonna do, these are called walkout to push-ups, all right? So if we are doing the traditional one, what it looks like is this, very simply, you put our hands on the ground, you walk out until you're in the position, we do a push-up, walk back, and stand up. That would be one. Okay, we're gonna do that 8 times, twice. Now, if you wanna do the assisted push-up version, you would start on your knees, straight up, okay, hands would go here, and same thing, you would walk your body out, down, walk your body back up until we're straight up, and that counts for one. Okay, so for my demonstration purposes, I'll do one of each. If you guys want to do two of the same or do one of each, doesn't matter, it's whatever your comfort level is. Okay, so my first time through, I'll demonstrate the assisted version. Second time, I'll do the traditional version. Okay, so everyone should be straight up and down, whether you're on your knees or standing. And on the count of 3, we walk out like a bear crawl, do our push-up, walk back until we're standing. All right, so here we go. We're gonna do 8 times. Ready? Go. So walking out, down, up, walk back. There's one.
Nice work, Gabriel. You're doing so good. Keep it up.
Good job, Caden.
3.
Good job, Finn. Nice push-ups.
4.
Alex, good work.
Good job.
Ellie, you too, you're doing so good. Keep it up. You guys are almost done.
Walk back. 6. I got 2 more on
these. These are tough, guys. Rahi, good work.
7. Last one. And eight. Good job, you guys. A little breather if you want, and give your arms a little wiggle there. Now remember, the big part of it, why it's called a walkout to push up, is the part where you actually do the crawl, then you go down, then we crawl back as well too. That's an important part of the exercise, right? It's not just fall forward, do a push-up, launch yourself back up, right? You actually have to do the little bear crawl, get into position, then push up, bear crawl back, okay? So we'll give you guys another 10 seconds or so to catch your breath. This next one, I'll do the demonstration for the traditional one. So that's for the one where you're actually standing all the way up. You go down, unassisted push-up, crawl all the way back, finish standing, okay? Again, if you want to do that one with me, you can. If you like the assisted one, that's fine too. All right. Everyone should be ready here. Got eight more, then our last water break of the day. Okay? Ready? Here we go.
Good job, Edward. Nice push-ups.
Good job, Ben.
Nice, Jay. Keep it up.
Two. Good job, you guys.
Nice work, Ellie. I know your arms are getting tired, guys, but keep it up.
Four.
You guys are doing super
good.
Five.
Good job, Caden.
Good job, buddy, Caden.
Six.
Go. Thanks. Good job.
Good. Thanks for. Good job, everyone.
Last one.
Yeah, actually, yeah.
Try to get this last one in, guys. Even if your arms are so tired, just try to get one more in.
Neat. Good job. Water break for everybody.
Good job, buddy. Keep it up.
Oh, grab your water.
Go ahead and unmute yourselves if you want during the water break.
Thanks, buddy.
You're welcome, buddy.
You're doing great, buddy.
Thank you.
Jay, are you starting to sweat?
I'm not starting to sweat. Good, I'm a lot of.
Good, yeah. Everybody hydrate. You guys must all be sweating so much. It looks like hard work.
While you're getting your water break, you want to go and find that ball. That would be great as well, too. All right, everyone seems to be done water break. Show me the ball to the camera so I can see that everyone's got it. Give it a little wave. Good stuff. Looks like everybody's got it. All right, so for this one, okay, what we're gonna do, again, we're getting our hand-eye coordination, our reaction time. So we're gonna start with the ball in our right hand. Now, what I wanna see for your catches, okay, I don't want to see your hand go under it to catch it. I want you to try and think like an eagle. You come in and you swoop it from the top. Okay. So our hand grasps it from the top. All right. It's not under and catch. It's top. All right. So the first one, we're going to start with our right hand. Okay. We're going to do drop to eagle catch. All right, and we're going to do it five times with our right hand. And we're going to see how many of your five you can catch. All right, so it looks like this. Ready? Drop, eagle catch. Okay, we're going to do that five times. Ready? Here we go. One. Two.
Nice job.
Three. Nice work, Gabriel. This one's tricky.
Four.
Good work, guys.
Brahi. If the ball falls, that's okay. Just pick it up and try again.
Good job.
Nice, Kaden.
If you're still going, that's fine. You don't need to keep up with my pace. I just want to see you do it five times. Good work. Good work. Looks like everyone's almost done. All right.
Nice, Ellie.
So what we're going to do now, we are going to switch hands now, okay? So we just did it with our right hand. Now we're going to do it with our left hand. Okay. Same basic idea. You're going to do it five times. See how many of them you catch. Ready? Here we go. One. Two.
Nice, Alex.
Three.
Good job, Ellie. You're trying really hard. Nice work.
Four.
Nice work, Jay. Five.
You're still going. That's fine. Make sure you finish your five, though.
If you drop the ball, that's okay, guys. Just pick it up and try again. This one's hard.
Good work, you guys. All right. And this is the last one. Last one, okay? What we're going to do is we're going to put it all together. All right? So we're going to drop with our right hand, catch with our left hand. And again, if you're not doing it every time, that's fine. Because you know what? Like we say every week, this is something you can work on at home, even when you're bored, you're watching TV, Netflix, whatever. It's something you can do while you're doing that and you're improving things as well at the same time. So what it looks like, we're going to do it five times. Okay. Drop with our right, catch with our left. One. Then you do the opposite. Okay. Drop with our left, catch with our right.
Good job, Zach.
Two.
Keep trying, guys. Everybody's doing super good. This one is hard, Kyle.
Three.
Good work, Grahi.
You're rocking it. Finn, you too. You're doing fantastic.
And five.
Kyle, this one's awesome.
Good work, you guys. Really good job.
This one really works your hand-eye coordination.
Yeah. So again, like I say, if you're struggling a little bit with it, that's fine. You're not going to be a master the first time you do everything in life, okay? Well, that's something you can practice, like I said. When you're just at home, you're bored, you got some time to kill, maybe you're waiting for your little brother or sister to get dressed so that you guys can hop in the car and go somewhere. This is something you can just do in your kitchen or your basement or your living room or wherever by yourself. Okay? So our last one, this is going to be our full body workout. All right? So we started with our legs. We did all the way up to our hips. Then our core, we did lots of core work today. Your tummies might be a little bit sore, but that's fine. It means you worked them hard. Then we were doing our chest and our shoulders, our triceps, everything. Worked on our hand-eye coordination, which means we got to put it all together now, all right? We are going to do one full body workout, okay? So what you're going to need is you are going to need your cans or your weights again for this one, okay? Go and grab your cans or your weights. Now, because we're only going to do one set of these because they're a little bit tricky, if you want to make it even more challenging, and this is entirely up to you, you can also put your backpack that's got some books on in it too. If you don't want to do that, that's fine. But this is our last one of the day, so if you've got a lot of energy still left and you really want to challenge yourself, you can throw on your backpack while you do this. Okay? But essentially what we are going to do is we are going to combine two exercises that we've already done before. So you guys should be pretty familiar with them. Okay. The first one is your lunge, right? So everyone knows your lunge. Okay. And then back, right? The second one is our shoulder raise and down, right? Remember with our shoulder raises, we don't get all the way up here, right? We get essentially straight out to make a T and then back. Now, the tricky part of this and why it's going to be your full body is you're going to be doing them both at the same time. Okay? I'll give you one demonstration from the front, one demonstration from the side, just so you can sort of see what your body should look like while you're doing it. Okay? So, From the front, it looks like this. Take your step forward, your lunge, out, and then up. Foot, out, up. Sounds like someone dropped something there. Okay, from the side, it's the same thing, but it's out, up, out, up. Okay, so it's the step of the lunge, and we go out. We are going to do one set, so we're going to do this once. We're going to do it 10 times, okay? So this is our last one, and then we're into our cool down, all right? So here we go. We'll get everyone ready. Get your feet about shoulder width apart. Hands are ready, and copy what we're doing here. Ready? Here we go. Step forward and back. One.
This is tricky, guys. Good work. I like how everybody's trying their best.
Two. Forward.
Good job, Rob.
Good work, everybody.
Nice work.
Three. Forward.
Gabriel, you're doing awesome.
Back. Four.
Nice. Two, Ellie.
Forward. Back. Five. We're halfway there. Forward.
Good job, guys.
Back. Six. Forward. Back. Seven. Forwards, back, eight. Really good job, Rahi. We got two more. Forwards, back, nine. And last one. Forwards, back, 10. Good work, you guys. That was a tricky one. All right, but it was working a little bit of everything. It did your legs, did your balance, so your core, did our shoulders. That was great. Okay. We're going to do our cool down really quickly here. Okay? So put your hands back off to the side.
Yeah.
Hands are back off to the side. All right. We're going to start. Look to the right. And you're going to bring your chin down to your chest and around. Finish looking left. Ready? All the way down to the left. And back. Chin is down. Look back to the right, and one more time. Chin's down, to the left, and back. Chin's down, to the right. Good job. We're gonna do our shoulder raises. So bring your shoulders up to your earlobes here, 10 times. Ready? One, two, three, four, five. Six, seven, eight, nine, one more, 10. Good job. All right, everyone's favorite. Get our right hand first. Stop. Grab the tips of our fingers. We don't pull on the fingers. Push out with your palm. We're gonna hold, hold, hold. Good stuff. You can give yourself a little wiggle. Okay, same thing with our left hand. Stop. And push out with our palm. Good.
I bet that stretch feels really good, everyone.
Good stuff. Okay, last one here. And again, we can do it by holding a wall, or if you can do it without help, that's fine too. We're gonna bring our knee up to our chest and we're gonna hold, okay, up to our chest. Gonna hold. Good stuff.
Thanks, you guys.
Awesome. And we gotta do our other leg too. We're gonna bring our knee up to our chest and hold. Good work, you guys. All right, everyone come on into the screen. Gonna do our awesome cheer to end things off here. Let's see those hands. All right, on the count of three, we're gonna say awesome. Ready? One, two, three.
Awesome.